The basic problem is that we are living in a virtual reality. We're living in a totally controlled environment, an environment that has been created by mass media. Now, many people, especially young people, accept unquestioningly the reality that is presented by the media. Popular culture, movies, television, music, carry messages about how society works and how people should behave. And so entertainment is not value-free. It has ideological content. It presents a worldview that influences the people who watch the programming. There is a reason why television networks and the music industry, the various companies, they have programming departments. The programming that we are constantly assaulted by throughout our life conditions us, it programs us to a particular worldview. Now, we may consider it normal because we were born into this system of lies and deception. In fact, deception has become part of the social framework of society. And because we were born into this situation and our parents were born into it and have suffered from it, we don't know any better. And so we don't necessarily see things as they are. We see things as we are. Now, there are two primary means by which people are manipulated and controlled. One is very simple, very basic, and that is simply the control of information. And the control of, if we don't have all of the facts on any particular topic, then our judgment is going to be no better than the quality of our information. And in spite of the fact that we have an information overload through all the information that's available on the internet and other sources, we have to have the presence of mind to be able to evaluate the information that we have available. And it's a matter of having to dig through and determine what's true, what are the lies, what are the half-truths, under that one basic heading, information control, where there has been a long-held consolidation of ownership of the different medias, press, publishing, film, music, television, consolidated ownership into the hands of very few individuals, the multinational corporations. Today, there are a half a dozen multinational corporations that are controlling the information and entertainment choices that people have. Working as an editor, it was easy to see how simple it is to change the meaning of an event or change the meaning of what someone says through editing. And so I was very well aware of how plastic and moldable media reality was. But I didn't fully appreciate the extent to which we are all manipulated and controlled by media, including those people who work in it. So using television as the prime example of how mental programming and mind control works, television is the most powerful weapon of psychological warfare in history. And yet, television, for many people, is a member of the family in the household.
It's the primary member.
Yes.
It runs the household.
Yes, well, not only that, but it's the primary source of information, and the television, in effect, represents an altar, a religious altar that the nation is worshiping before. Many people don't think about the things that affect them subconsciously, because generally they don't know what to look for until someone comes around and starts pointing these things out to them, and then they can see how we are all influenced by unseen forces without our conscious awareness. In fact, the ultimate control is to control people without their conscious awareness. Again, television is a prime example. Think back to whenever you have observed young children or older adults sitting watching television. They have this glassy-eyed, vacant look in their eyes because they are in a trance state, in a hypnotic state of mind. This is very important, very significant, that the medium of television has the capacity to do this, and it doesn't matter what you're watching. the flickering effect of the television image. Although it appears to be static and stationary, it is actually flickering. We don't see it consciously, but subconsciously, the repeating visual pattern of the flicker induces the trance state. And that's the basic principle behind hypnotic programming, is that you get the subject to focus the attention of the conscious mind on one of the five senses. So in the case of watching television, we're talking about the sense of sight and the flickering image. In the case of sound, any repeating sound pattern will induce the trance state. Now, why this is important is that we are more suggestible to mental programming during this state of mind than at any other time. We're very vulnerable to manipulation at this time, because the first order of business for a propagandist or an advertiser is to create the circumstances that will induce a state of mind that is favorable to the reception of their message. And that state of mind is the hypnotic state of mind, making television extremely important in this whole process of creating a unified mindset among the entire population. Have you ever bought something and then later on wondered why did you buy it? I think we've all had that kind of experience.
Quite a few times.
Well, that's a common everyday illustration of being triggered to make a purchase based on a conditioned response that has been built into us to have a preference for a particular product. In fact, that is the whole point of programming, whether it be by an advertiser or a propagandist. There's really no difference between the two. One's selling products, the other is selling ideas. The whole point is to build into us a conditioned response where we will respond automatically without thinking with a preference for a particular idea or preference for a particular product. And that is the whole point of programming. If you think about it, whenever you hear news broadcasters speak, you realize that regardless of their ethnic background, whether they be black, white, Hispanic, or Oriental, they all have a similar manner of speaking. They have a speech pattern that is associated with the dissemination of true factual information on a news broadcast. Their speech pattern is similar to the pattern speech of a hypnotist. The news broadcaster looks directly into the camera and into the eyes of the viewer. Another hypnotic technique.
Mm-hmm.
The newscaster is an authority figure, encouraging the acceptance of the information.
Yes.
People will accept information that comes from an accepted and respected authority. And then the repetition of the information over and over and over again is what builds that conditioned response, so that whenever they are presented with the information again, then they'll accept it automatically without thinking about it.
Do you think that the media is complicit in sort of the mind control aspect? Do you think that they are, because I'm a firm believer that the media is completely controlled.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, and that's my feeling as well, in my experience, that the media has become the fourth branch of government.